Okay, I'm back with a new video, and this is going to be a typical Carrie video where I'm trying to do and show and explain you something that is super simple yet extremely complicated. And I can't help it. This is one of those things that I repeat every year, and don't ask me why it works, it does. And it's a combination of water magic, flower magic, candle magic, and not magic. So you need a lighter for your candle, and you need a candle, because else you can't light the candle if you don't have a candle. And I'm starting to ramble. I don't know why this happens lately. It's, you know, my mind is like a sieve. And string or rope, I love the silky stuff. You can use whatever color you like. If yellow feels good to you, then you use yellow. If white feels better, then you use white. I love this. And it's a little bit silky and shiny. So, candle, lighter, string. And you need a bowl with water. And I put a little bit of elderberry flowers in it. Now, for some odd reason, after having done this for a lot of years, 36 years or something, it works best if you use either water from a forest stream or tap water. And you can add a little bit of salt. Don't go crazy with the salt. It's about the water and the flowers and the bowl. Yellow doesn't seem to work that well, but white and blue, bluish, purplish flowers work best. So, and use fresh. That's another thing. You don't have to use many or much or a lot, just a little bit. As you can see, there's just a little bit of white stuff in it, just a little bit, to give it a fresh, nice vibe. Now, this ritual works best when you do it outside, when you have a little river in your backyard, or you have a forest stream nearby, or an ocean or something, then that's fun. And the water automatically takes away everything that's bugging you or wants to attack you, or jealousy or hate or frustration or things like that. But most of us are stuck in a ritual room, ritual chamber, and this is fine. Now, what do you do after the ritual? I want to address this right now, else I get questions in the comments section again. Like I said, if you have a river in your backyard or a forest stream somewhere, then the water takes away everything that has to do with the ritual right away. In my case, I'm just going to pour it outside, in front of my front door, just to, you know, block it. It's done, it's clean, it's cleared, it's protected, so that's it. If you, for some odd reason, feel better to you just pour it in a jar and bring it far away, somewhere in the desert or a jungle or whatever, then you do that, okay? I'm just telling you what I do. So this is my candle. I already prepared it a little bit. It has 8 strings that look like this. One side is going around the candle, and you do a prayer or express your intention when you make the knot. On the other side is the same knot. That's the one that you're going to put your finger through. So you need a candle, and like I said, in this case, my preference goes to purple, dark purple, purplish, violet, and there are 8 strings that you need. One goes that way, one goes that way, one goes that way, the one goes that way, you know, zigzag it. And then you put it around your fingers. Let me put away the bowl for just a bit and then show you guys what I'm doing. It's quite easy and complicated at the same time. So you have to make sure that you make the knots and express your intention at the same time while you are knotting it or knitting it or making a knot or and zigzag. That's another thing that's important. It neutralizes the evil eye. It neutralizes what you're going to do. So then you end up with this. You can hang it on your wall if you want to, but you're going to place your ball there. Then you take your lighter and you're going to light the candle. Nothing complicated or whatever. So then you're going to do this and this and this and this. My daughters were extremely skilled in, you know, this game where you have to, why is my camera? I'm just going to sit here for a bit. And then you focus on and you dip the candle bottom in the water. Don't go crazy because it's fire. You don't want to play with fire. You want to remove fire and hate and frustration. You can just play a little bit with it. And that's okay. Dance around with the candle. So water magic, flower magic, not magic, candle magic, and dance, you know, and relax. And what you have to do now is go through your neighborhood. And don't forget anybody. You first, your closest neighbors on the left, both, including the child, the boy and another boy. Then you go to the right, who's living there, an old hag. And I'm not joking. With two daughters and their men and their 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 children. And the maid who cleans the house. And the one who does the groceries. Then who brings you your groceries. Then you go to the neighbors on the right or on the left or in front of you. And try to think about as many people that you can think of. So you can also start with your family, parents, mom, dad, brother, his wife, his son, his daughter. And then you go to your aunt with 1, 2, 3, 4 children and make it dance. It's easier maybe to just take a smudge stick and smudge the hell into your house, but it's smelly and it's dirty and I hate incense, unless I make it myself. And no, I'm not going to do a video about it, I think, unless I'm in the mood. But you know, you get into a more of a, you have to feel the energy. And this is, you know, you don't have to worry. For some old reason, if the candle goes down or the flame, you know, goes down or burns down or whatever, this still gives you enough balance to, you know, do the whole thing. I can do this. I can play with this for hours. It relaxes me. It brings me in a meditative state. It reminds me of all the people that I hate. It reminds me of all the people that hate me or dislike me or have their doubts about me or whatever. And old friends from school, because maybe people that you don't see anymore, that you never meet again, that you haven't seen in about 20 years or maybe more, have this feel about her nose is crazy and her eyes are more beautiful than mine. So, you know, you have to get into a meditative state where you let the candle dance. And that's another thing, a practical thing. How do you call melted wax? If it falls into the water, it's not going to hurt you or your clothes or your table or whatever. It just falls into the bowl. And then you're done. You're done. And you only have to do this once a year or something. I'm going to do a video about which jars or which bottle. Pardon me. I think tomorrow. but this is fun. To me, this is fun to let a candle dance and not really touch it and burn away negativity in the meantime and, you know, get a feel for what's going on in your environment as if as for family and neighbors and friends that maybe aren't friends, you know, burn away everything. Everything that wants to go after you or things that you're more successful or more eccentric or you have more beautiful dresses. There is always a reason for people to, you know, look at you like, you know, this look. And sometimes it looks like this, and in the meantime it's this, you know, so you have to go from one to another. If you, by any chance, think later when you're done, think about people that you forgot to take into consideration, then you just repeat and get rid of it then. But at some point, enough should be enough. So that's it, see you next time. Bye.